A very warm greeting to all on this Teacher's Day. Today, I, Daya Vaghani from Department of English MK Bhavnagar University, taking an opportunity to offer a short video lecture on Frantz Fanon's novel, The Wretched of the Earth. So friends, before jump to the work of art, let us begin with the introduction of the author, Frantz Fanon. So Frantz Fanon, the full name of the Frantz Fanon book is Frantz Omar Fanon, and he was born in 1925 at Martinique. Martinique is a Caribbean island, and he was born under French colonial rule. And Fanon is served in Free French Army during World War II. So he was also participated in World War II. And after that, he sent to the French and studied medicine and become psychiatric. Okay. And if we look at his notable work, so in his lifetime, he wrote three notable works. First is The Wretched of the Earth. Second is Black Skin, White Mask. And the third notable work is A Dying Colonialism. Okay, so these are his notable works. And only at the age of 36, he was died because of cancer in Algeria. Okay, now let's look at the overview of the novel, The Wretched of the Earth. So the novel, The Wretched of the Earth, is published in, it was published in 1961. Published in 1961, and the preface of this novel is written by Jean-Paul Sartre. Okay. So the book, if we look at the book, so the book is classified under the category of modern classic. And in this book, Fanon tries to speak about the term decolonization. This is very important term in the novel. Colonization. Okay, so this work is a seminal work which helps us to understand certain terms like decolonization, what is political violence, what is power structure, etc. This novel is divided into 5 chapters. Now let's look at the name of the chapter. The first chapter is divided into 2 sections. The first is on violence and the second is violence in international context. Violence in international context. The second chapter is the grandeur and weakness of spontaneity. Grandeur and weakness of spontaneity. Yes? And the name of the third chapter is on the trials and tribulations. Trials and tribulation. The fourth chapter is also divided into 2 sections. The first is on national culture. And the second section is mutual foundations. Mutual foundations. Now, fifth chapter. It is also divided into 2 sections.
The first is colonial war and mental disorder. Colonial war and mental disorder. In the second section is from the North Africans. From the North Africans. Okay. So these are the five chapters of this novel. And what does Fanon explain? What is the whole book about? The book is explained how and why colonialism should be stopped. He also speak that how colonialism happened. Is it a pre-planned agenda or is it like an accidental? He very clearly claims that colonialism is a accidental by colonial power. Colonial power. So these 13 things Fanon tries to explain as an introductory note of the novel, The Wretched of the Earth. So let's discuss about chapter 1. Chapter 1. In chapter 1, Fanon speaks about the three terms: decolonization, power structure, and political divisions. Decolonization, power structure, and third one is political division. Okay, so he speaks about the term decolonization and the effect of decolonization on the masses or on the peoples. Okay, so now you will be thinking that what is decolonization and what is colonizer and what is colonized mass. You would be here from here and there. Yes, and it's all the confusing term, right? But now just forget about all these things and just look at the word decolonization. So it's a very simple term. As Fanon explained by saying that it is a liberation of a nation and the restoration of that nation of the people. The two words are very important for decolonization is liberation and restoration of the nation of the people. Yes? So this is the very simple definition given by Fanon to the decolonization. So we will be thinking that how can you do the colonization? Is it by war or is it by shaking hand? Fanon clearly says that colonization never be done by gentleman's agreement or by shaking hand. He says that colonialism will be happen only by the violence. It will happen only by the violence. Now imagine, what would be the mentality of the colonizer and colonized? Will they have a happy kind of feeling or will they have a sad kind of feeling? Just imagine, it is very simple. So we are looking at the mentality of the colonizer people and colonized people. So obviously colonizer will have a fear inside, the fear of decolonization. What will colonized people think? Yes, obviously they will be happy because they are going to make their nation. Colonized people will have always desire for decolonization. They always have desire for decolonization. So what Fanon tries to explain here that the colonizer and the colonized, both are totally different. And he also explained in the novel about the two worlds, the world of colonizer and the world of colonized people. So now, what separates colonizer from the colonized? So the two things Fanon explained is that soldiers, barracks and the police power. These two things separate colonizer from the colonized people. And he clearly says that the world of colonizer and the world of colonized is separate totally from the political power, from the weapons or ammunition, and from the soldiers' barrack and police power. Now, do they both have equal status? No, they don't have equal status. Yes, because they have a clear insight and they have a desire to decolonization. They are ruler. Yes, colonizer is always ruler and master, while they are subordinate. Yes, the other things that separate is colonizer always have a power, while colonized people are slave. They are always in suppression. So these things separate colonizer from the colonized people. So for these two division of people, colonizer and colonized, Fanon used the word Manichaean. Manichaean world. So what is the meaning of Manichaean? Manichaean is a Persian religion during the 3rd century. And this religion is concerned with the struggle between good and evil. And so it is a contradictory perspective towards the values and towards the morals. So Fanon used this word as an analogy to describe the colonialism. Okay, friends. So that's all for today and for these topics. And I have given the link for online quiz in the description box, so you can give the test and you will receive the automatic submission.